Good late Sunday evening. I'm certified meteorologist Nick Kelly checking in on the September 17th of 2017. And so much for much of a warm-up today, thanks to clouds, rain, and thunderstorms, especially this morning. We just struggled to warm up at all today. I think we'll do better tomorrow, though, and certainly as we go through the rest of the week ahead. Let's recap how today went, though, starting with this morning. We had a bit of a break to start the early overnight out, but then once we got closer to sunrise, more rain and thunderstorms worked in. It was definitely quite a bit wet for late Sunday morning around here. A little break in the action, and then we're going to continue to see at least a few more waves of rain and thunderstorms as we go through the rest of the night. So far, though, going back to yesterday, 1.7 inches on average in most of the heaviest downpours of rain, but you can go individual spots, especially with the heavier rains picked up on the Kansas side. Some spots, radar estimates suggesting 3, 4, if not close to 5 inches of rain. So at the very least, we are catching up on rain around here. There's no argument about that. The Skywatch Storm Tracker, last check, had us quiet. But again, I do expect more rain chances on the way. I'll show you where those rain chances will come from in a few. First, the temperatures. That's right, it starts at 227 this morning, this view of temperatures, and that was about as warm many of us got for our Sunday around here, especially Joplin at 74, 73 in Parsons, 72 in Anderson. Then as the rain and thunderstorms swept through going through the morning and into this early afternoon, the temperatures definitely responded to the clouds and the rain. 67 was what it was in Joplin at 227, 65 in Anderson. At least a few spots like Fredonia and Chenier did manage to go to at least 77 degrees. That was about as warm as we got, though, throughout portions of the day. Right now, most spots, at least now being 948, temperatures mainly sitting in the upper 60s. I think we'll only drop off a degree or two more because we have enough moisture in place, clouds in place, and even with rain chances coming in, we're not going to cool down much more from where we are right now. Wider view with the Skywatch Storm Tracker does show more thunderstorms developing in the panhandle to Texas and beginning to work into Oklahoma. This is eventually going to fill in and head our way as we go into tomorrow morning. So definitely have the rain gear handy as we begin the morning commute to work and school. It's all because of a front that's still stalled right on top of us, but it's going to rearrange itself as we go into tomorrow. On top of that, we have another front. Yesterday, it was sitting out in the Gulf of Alaska getting its act together and then has quickly moved onshore to North America, especially southwestern Canada, and eventually the northwestern parts of the United States. That will keep some rain chances around as well. So if we look at the week ahead and see when the best rain chances look to set up, I think it's tonight, and I expect it to continue at least for a portion of your Monday. Then going into late Monday night into Tuesday, maybe a few random thunderstorms, and then that second system working into the U.S. will pay us a visit by Thursday morning. That could give us some scattered storms as well. So at the very least, these storm chances that I have on the horizon don't look severe. So at the very least, it'll make sure that we get caught up with rain because we could still certainly use some. Here's how we look for the rest of the night. The warm front starts to lift back to the north. So as long as that's around, let's keep the cloud cover in place and the rain chances in place too. And again, we're not going to drop off much more from here. I think we'll only drop back into the middle to upper 60s. And as long as that front's still close by as we go into Monday afternoon, let's say in the afternoon we start to trend partly sunny. We can still see a few thunderstorms around. I think by late afternoon, though, we'll at least get a chance to dry out a bit. I think we will definitely have more sunshine tomorrow. And as a result, we should be warmer tomorrow. Let's start at 66 in the morning, 75 by noon, afternoon highs right around 81. Then as we go into late Monday night and into Tuesday morning, we could see a few thunderstorms to start things out, mainly on the Kansas side. But as we roll in the 7-day forecast, again, not widespread rain chances for your Tuesday. It'll be 89 Tuesday afternoon under otherwise partly to mostly sunny skies. Definitely mostly sunny Wednesday with highs near 93. Then that next system pays us a visit Thursday morning with some thunderstorms as a result. Otherwise partly sunny and still hot with highs near 90. Looking at upper 80s and a pretty quiet weekend ahead of us overall. And it'll be quite a warm weekend as we kick off fall on Friday and head right into our first full weekend of the fall season. Have a good night. Have a great Monday.